We are here at the in Frankfurt at the end of the 2 days of the Action Conference, and with Christos from Greece. So we had actually a workshop even on the relation between the big moments, collective big moments, even at European level, and the daily struggle and the local and the national level. So we say basically that the big moments must be tools, and Blockupy also must be a tool that must be useful for daily struggle. So how can you elaborate on this from the Greece point of view?
Yeah, I think one of the problems, as we said in the conference, it is how you give a very material, concrete essence, let's say substance, to these symbolic moments. How you turn these symbolic moments that bring all the different struggles in Europe together. And you make it advance real struggles to feed back, you know, the real struggles. So in the problem in Greece, we live somehow in a different temporality, which is an expression of the different stages of the development of the political struggle in Greece. The first thing it is that the struggles in the everyday life, like all the social self-organized solidarity movement, all the VOME, etc., it is a struggle together with for survival, but also a political struggle, either to oppose the Troika regime or to build alternatives further than the crisis for a longer kind of social transformation. And this is very, because it is linked directly with the issue of to get by every day with the life, with so many kind of more, the unemployed are more than the people that they have work, okay, to put it very simply. It is much more important for the life of the people. These big events should integrate and be a reflection of these struggles. And this is the problem we face in Greece, and also the problem that we in Greece, unlike the rest of the European countries, the issue of political power, it is an issue that you have to take positions. So the euro, for example, the European elections are going to be discussed in relation to what is the solution, the position of Greece within euro, within Troika, or outside euro, etc. And this is going to be crystallized in a polarization between the pro-austerity, pro-Troika governments, parties that they compose the government, and the anti-austerity parties, and mainly the radical left and Syriza, that they oppose this. So the domination of this kind of polarization, it makes more difficult to introduce another element of action without integrating it in the local conditions and in this kind of national dimension of the struggle. So, from our point of view, it is a difficult task because it gives us one more thing to do on all of these things that we've been doing. And with unforeseeable political developments, it's very asymmetric, struggle in Greece, because you cannot plan. You have some initiative of the government, like evacuating the television broadcaster, so you have to do something about that. Yeah. But anyway, so we have to create an initiative to create a space that different movements, they can take on board the task to connect these struggles with the European dimension in a more concrete way.
So, more or less the same than in Italy, very similar in many respects. And so, actually, we ended with at least two appointments, no? To the ECB opening event in the fourth quarter of 2014, and the week of action with that actually is more than 1 week, with a nice coincidence of dates, no? Say just before. And basically, the concept is that what we are saying, no, to the Troika at European level is you have to pay a toll at least, no? Now you pay the toll, because you want to open the ECB, then you pay the toll. You want to struggle on our life, and then we struggle back, and you have to pay the toll here and now at local level, and that's probably that integration that make easier, no?
Yeah.
And that makes the European level a tool. So what about this kind of integration and the struggle in the week of action and the ECB shutting down?
Yeah, let's start from your second point. I said in the opening panel, you know, of this preparation and meeting for Brocupy that we don't need to have a Blocupy in order to show to the people where the enemy is. This is one point. I think people know where the enemy is, maybe in different pace or degrees, more in Southern Europe, less in Germany. Okay, but what we need to show it is that we block the opening of the ECB exactly because we are united as European people against the EU. I think this is how we have to approach the Blocupy process and moment. Okay, this is one thing about this week. I think that we need more than a week. First of all, it is we have to have this week. I totally agree on that. It is a problem in Greece this week because it falls exactly between two elections, the municipality elections and the EU, and the second round of the municipality elections, which will dominate the whole political life and discourse. It's going to be very difficult for people to mobilize, even those that are against elections. It's not easy to build something during this period. Of course, they construct a fertile ground to say something about these issues. But as I told before, the issue of euro in Greece also amalgamates in concrete political decisions and participation in the elections for or against. Okay, so we have to work out somehow how to build coalitions and a clever strategy in order to combine these weeks of protest with highlighting the alternative Europe, even regardless of the what its person will do in the ballot. Okay, just one positive thing about this week is that symbolically it is between the 15th of May, which was the first day of the Spain. M15 of the Indignados in Spain, and the 25th of May, which was the first day of Syntagma Square occupation.
That's nice.
So, and I think this one, from one end of Europe to the other end of Europe, it can describe somehow, we miss the northern point, but anyway, it describes somehow the frame within which we have to struggle all together.
Yeah, struggling frame, so Harman block.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you,
and
Christos.
Produce.
And produce. Bye.